these cubes will keep them a little bit busy, but once they start to see the enrichment, it's all fair game.
Oh, nice. So, Chris, do our otters with their different personalities have different favorites of toys?
You know, they really do, and they also have different and favorite food items. So what they're really doing, and you're going to see this, is they're really going to be hunting for certain types of food. And so here comes Ivy. She's the youngest one out here. She immediately grabs a dog toy. Abby over here, she's sorting. She grabs one, throws it away. Nope, I want this one. This is Rosa, our old lady. She's going to be a little bit pickier, and she's going to grab the easier objects. So you can see, for those of you who voted for small dog toys, they all grabbed a small dog toy first off. It's also the easiest for them to do. So I'm not surprised by any of that. But you're going to see they're going to eat, pull out all the clam and the shrimp and the squid from their toys. And they're immediately going to swim back over to grab another one.
Yeah, so they have a good appetite, and they can go through a lot of toys in no time. You might also be able to observe some natural behavior, because this is what the toys are stimulating in them. They really try to get the food out of the toys and might bang the toy against the wall or against the window. And Chris, one reason why we use toys instead of live food on exhibit, it is all for a reason.
It is, actually. So the biggest reason we don't give live food on exhibit is because our windows are acrylic. They're not glass. And I don't know if you can see it, but over the corner, now you can probably hear it. That is Ivy. So our 8-year-old does not believe she should have to open things herself. She prefers to use the exhibit or the windows. So right now she's smashing a very hard dog toy on the acrylic. Now, if she was to do that with a crab shell or a clam, she would instantly be scratching up the window. So we try to give all these toys that are a little bit softer or made of a material that won't scratch the windows, and that they can still pound and bang and do their natural foraging behavior, but without destroying the windows.
Chris, I saw that in between the toys, you also have just ice cubes into the holding area. Is there a specific reason for ice cubes?
Yeah, there actually is. So this big toy we have right here, we've done a few things. So you see these balls. So this is our ball pit. Some of them have shrimp in them, and some of them just have clam juice. And this was actually Courtney's idea. She created the first ball pit, and since then we've been making a lot of ball pits. But you'll see the otters will start foraging. They're going to come up and start looking for the ones with food in it first, because they can tell the difference. But we use ice in all different forms all day long. In fact, one of our biggest improvements to the sea otter exhibit a few years ago was that we gave the otters their own ice machine. And they have an ice machine that makes about 400 pounds of ice a day. And we will go through that every single day sometimes. And the reason that they like to eat ice is that, one, it's fresh water, so it tastes different. They live in salt water. A nice side effect is that it provides them with fresh water. They get all of their water from the food they metabolize, but this is just added water, which is good for them. But in addition to that, they're designed and built to just crunch and chew. And if you give a sea otter anything, they put it in their mouth and they try to chew it apart. That's their number one response to everything. And so this allows them to chew something that doesn't destroy the exhibit, which is actually very, very nice for my staff and I.
Chris, I was always wondering, we are utilizing so many toys for the sea otters. Are the sea otters somehow involved in cleaning up their exhibit?
Somewhat involved. The otters have been trained to here's Rosa, our old lady, coming up, and she's sniffing and sniffing and she's sniffing, and yep, there goes another dog toy. Always going to be a favorite here, especially with her. She really enjoys the dog toys. But yes, they've all been trained, especially, you know, Rosa too, to go down and retrieve toys off the bottom of the tank or floating in the surface. But usually we have so many toys in the exhibit for them to play with, because if you don't give a sea otter something to do, they will do something and they will create their own game or project and it is always to the detriment of the exhibit. So we have to turn around and fix something. So we give them a lot of toys all the time. You'll see them in the exhibit all the time. But yeah, they are trained to retrieve them, to give them back to us. But we also have a big volunteer dive program, and our volunteers and our staff divers actually clean up the tank completely every Wednesday and Saturday.
That's good to know. Thanks, you shared that with me, because my kids were always asking me, why do your otters have more toys than we ever had? So now we know the answer to that question.
Yeah, we definitely do. We definitely have a lot of toys, and I'm always looking for new toys. Every time I go to a pet store to buy food for my pets at home, I always go to the dog toy section so I can see if there's any new toys that have come out that these guys don't have.
Chris, I understand it takes a lot of time and care and observation from your side to see what really is other artists interested. I understand that you cannot repeat too many enrichments in a row because they get bored very easily. So is that the fun part of your job?
It is. We spend the staff spends a huge amount of time every day making enrichments and creating ideas and coming up with new things. We actually even have a calendar that the staff uses that tells them every day what enrichment activities to do so that we are not repetitive, so that one day to the next is very different. The one thing that we use all the time that is a little repetitive, but the otters never get tired of it, is ice cubes. This is Abby sitting here. She's checking everything out. Hi, how about not me? There you go. Looking, searching for more toys, searching, wondering why she can't have anything. Where are you going? She is, Abby is somebody who is incredibly, I want to say lazy, but she definitely will always pick the enrichment that is the easiest to do. So right now she's looking for anything that she doesn't have to really work at. And I guarantee that's what she's doing. She's going around looking and looking.
Well, I'm pretty sure some of my our members who are watching Abby can relate to that. We are all different. And you mentioned earlier, with different personalities, I always were thinking, oh, man, Rosa is more like me, more like on the calmer side. And then Abby is going for an easy enrichment. But you have so much knowledge and work with them 24/7 technically, right, to see that they are adjusting, that they are well, and we want to see that our animals are balanced and healthy in our care.